so, so much, Vancouver. My, 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 this is a very nice vibe. I'm into this. Something quite interesting today. Maybe less interesting to you, but I don't know if you know this. I've adopted a scooter on this tour. And I use it to get around the arena because I've never played in a venue this big before. It's a lot of walking, so I got the scooter and I sort of zip around the place and check everything out. But today I scooted right through where you're sitting tonight and I discovered ice. There's ice underneath you right now, and I know that sounds so obvious. This is your thing, but it's so beautiful to me that there's ice underneath us right now. Blew my mind. And that's like the kind of sort of strange magical touch that I guess I associate with Canada at this point. You guys, there's something going on here. There's some sort of strange magic. It's actually not dissimilar to New Zealand where I'm from. The fact that you can walk down, you know, a street in the city and see these mountains covered in snow, that is very much akin to where I come from. I love that. And you guys were actually some of the first people to really take my music and do crazy things with it. I remember, I think this was the country that maybe Pure Heroin was like, this was like one of the biggest places with the Pure Heroin. And for Military Man, which is amazing. I remember the first time I got recognized by an airport official was in Vancouver. Which always feels very exciting when the airport dude, the lady is like, sup? You're like, yes, it's happening for me. But no, you've always been so sweet, and we're just so, so grateful every time we get to come here and hang out with you guys. It means so much that after all this time, so many of you still want to come and hang out, really. Because I know it was a while. I was away for a while doing my special things in New Zealand, writing down my special notions. And I learned a lot in that time. I wrote a lot of interesting shit down, some of which I've gotten to share with you, some of which is still languishing in my computer. But this song I'm gonna sing you is one of the most important things I think I'll ever write. It's special because for the first time I looked myself dead in the eyes and I thought, this is who you are. You know those moments in your life when you're able to see, this is who I am. They don't happen very frequently, but they are so powerful. And this one, it had been playing on my mind for a while. I'd had a few sort of catastrophic arguments with people, sort of centered around this idea that sometimes it hurts people, this thing that I do, this thing where I take a conversation or take a moment or look at someone asleep next to me and write something down. And someone said to me, you know, who do you think you are? What do you think you're doing, basically? And it took me a minute, and then I woke up in the middle of the night and I just wrote down a sentence, and that sentence was, bet you rue the day you kissed a rider in the dark. To be a good man for someone else. Sorry, I was never good like you. Stood on my chest and kept me down. Hated hearing my name on the lips of a crowd. Did my best to exist just for you. I bet you rue the day you kissed the rider in the dark. I bet you rue the day you kissed the rider in the dark. And now she's gonna play and sing and lock you in her heart. I bet you rue the day you kissed the rider in the dark. When you see me, will you say I've changed? I ride the subway, read the signs, I let the seasons change my mind. I love you since I started meeting you. I bet you rue the day you kissed the rider in the dark. She's gonna play and sing and lock you in her heart. I bet you rue the day you kissed the rider in the dark. Darkest hours, I stumbled on a secret power. I'll find a way to be without you.